this liturgy, as we gather here today to remember our dearly beloved, those who have gone before us to the Lord, we give thanks to Almighty God for the time He spent with us. We certainly acknowledge our own grief, but we also trust that our Lord is with us and will be there to comfort us. At this time, I just need to reiterate some of our usual practices that have become usual since the beginning of June when we were able to reopen our churches, particularly in light of the fact that unfortunately we did have a positive case of COVID this past Sunday. I need to ask everyone, just as a reminder, please, during the Mass, please make sure you're wearing a mask that covers your nose and your mouth during the duration of the Mass. And we also ask that you kindly please make sure you are at least 6 feet away from anyone who is not part of your immediate household. Again, we're doing this not to be mean, but rather we want to comply with the rules, and also we want to keep everyone as safe as possible. So thank you for doing that. Thank you for taking advantage of the chairs we have staggered throughout the church. We do appreciate that. At this time, we ask Almighty God for His continued love, His healing, and His mercy. Lord Jesus, You came to reconcile us to one another and to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, You heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, You intercede for us with Your Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And together let us praise God's holy name with a Gloria.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise You, we bless You, we adore You. We give You thanks for Your great glory.
prayers, O Lord, and as our faith in your Son, raised from the dead, is deepened, so may our hope of resurrection for your departed servants also find new strength. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the righteous are in the hand of God, and no torment will ever touch them. In the eyes of the foolish, they seem to have died, and their departure was thought to be a disaster, and their going from us to their destruction, but they are at peace. For though in the sight of others they were punished, they hope, but their hope was full of immorality. Having been disciplined a little, they will receive great good, because God tested them and found them worthy of himself. Like gold in the furnace, he tried them, and like a sacrificial burnt offering, he accepted them. In the time of their visitation, they will shine forth and will run their sparks through the stubble. They will govern nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord will reign over them forever. Those who trust in him will understand truth, and the faithful will abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are upon his holy ones, and he watches over his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. Are you aware that we were all baptized into Jesus Christ? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too may live in newness of life. For if we have grown into union with him through a death like this, he shall also be united with him in resurrection. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that our sinful body might be done away with, that we might no longer be in slavery to sin. For a dead person has been absolved from sin. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We gather here today mindful of God's presence with us, and mindful of God's presence among us. We gather here today because we know that we love God, and we know that he is with us, particularly when we are vulnerable, particularly when we are meek, particularly when we are of humble of heart. Consider the Beatitudes, Matthew chapter 5. Blessed are the poor in spirit, blessed are the meek, blessed are those who mourn. On the surface level, they seem to be contradictory statements. Why would they seem to be blessed occasions? They're blessed because when we realize our dependence upon God, it can bring us to a healthy sense of humility. It doesn't mean that we think poorly of ourselves. Instead, the idea is that we think of ourselves as dependent upon God, and we let God be God. And when we gather here today, I'm sure there are a variety of emotions you're feeling. Perhaps some sadness, some anger, confusion, perhaps, a sense of despair, a sense of loss. We gather here today to remember our loved ones who have gone before us. On one hand, we're happy for them. We are. We do trust in the message that Jesus has shared with us in Holy Scripture. Consider what we heard just a few moments ago from John's Gospel. "And this is the will of him who sent me, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given me, but raise it up on the last day." Consider how Jesus, before his own passion, death, and resurrection, raised Lazarus from the dead. He groaned, and then he called out, "Lazarus, come out." And Lazarus came out of the tomb. Likewise, we trust that when our loved ones pass from this world to the next, they are also called by Jesus, who brings our loved ones into the heavenly home that his Father, our Heavenly Father, has created for us. And we are grateful for that. And likewise, we also see that there is wisdom in being part of a community. There is wisdom in being part of a faith community, because we do trust that we are here to support one another. We are here to be able to take care of each other, particularly when we are vulnerable. On the local level, I am very grateful for all the assistance we have at this liturgy today. Grateful for the presence of Father Don Saluzniak, our pastor emeritus. Very grateful also, of course, for our Prevent ministry team. Thank you so much for all that you do. Thank you for taking such wonderful care of those in our community who have to experience the sting of a loss and the wonderful ministry you exercise for them. Thank you. Also grateful, too, for our choir. Thank you so much for being here today, for gifting us with your talents and to enhance this liturgy with your music. Grateful also to the assistance of our videographer extraordinaire, Jamin. Thank you for recording this Mass, so this way it is available live on Facebook, and it will also be available later on today to be archived on my YouTube page for those who cannot join us here today, but wish to be with us in spirit, you might say. We gather here today because we know the wisdom in being able to support one another. We know the wisdom to lean on God and to be able to trust that, yes, somehow, some way, God will help us to make sense of the pain and the suffering that we experience, and God will transform that into a sense of hope. And it's not that we don't miss our loved ones after some time. It's not that we don't miss them, but the idea is we're able to be at peace with the fact that they are gifts from God. They came to us from God. We trust they now return to God. And we trust that God is still calling us to be his witnesses in this world, to go forth and to have a sense of purpose. And so, in some ways, we might be able to relate to the workers in the vineyard whom the owner of the vineyard called at dawn, at midday, and even at dusk. We might relate to those workers because, like those workers, we may feel our calling change from dawn to the mid-afternoon until dusk. Our identity maybe changes a little bit. How we identify with others might change throughout our lives, but we do see that we are part of God's family, and that is a blessing, it truly is. And so in a few moments, you'll be invited to be able to take a flower, and your loved one's names will be read aloud. And again, I'm thankful for our Bereavement Ministry for doing such a wonderful job with this. You can tell that this has a lady's touch, because I don't think there were too many guys who would be able to do this so nicely. So thank you very much for doing this. It's very well done. Appreciate it. And certainly be assured of the prayers of this faith community, not just today, but in the days to come. God bless you. God bless you.
Salvatore Amico, Joseph Amadio III, Patricia Bradford, Marlene Brady. Sybil Briggs, Constance Coakley DeLilly, Dominic Collar, Amy Conroy, Frank DiGiacomo Sr. John Michael DeRosa, Vito DiRico, Richard Enfield, Rose Faulkner, Ronald Ferrari. Charles Funk, Mary Giardino, Karen Hauser, Annie Mancini, Nick Masella. Benay Mayberry, Teresa Mercer, Louise Moscone, Charles Papa, Jane Putnam.
Jesus, remember them when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember them.
Raymond Roy, Phyllis Ruggiero, Francis Samarco, Albert Sanchez.
Please stand. Now that we've been nourished by the word of God, let us now turn our attention to the needs of the world with a prayer of the faithful.
For church leaders, may God draw them ever closer to Himself in their mission of spreading the gospel. We sing to the Lord. May they be blessed with fortitude in their efforts to protect life from conception through natural birth. We sing to the Lord.
Hear us, Savior, hear our prayer. Hear us, Savior, hear our prayer.
For all the sick, may the healing presence of God bring them comfort and peace today and always. We sing to the Lord.
Hear our Savior, hear our prayer. Hear our Savior, hear our prayer.
For those gathered here today, may the Lord strengthen us in virtue. We sing to the Lord.
Hear our Savior.
Dead. May they rest joyfully in the presence of God. We sing to the Lord.
Hear our Savior, hear our prayer. Hear our Savior, hear our prayer.
We pray these prayers through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord.
Amen.
Amen. May be seated.
Please join us in singing our offering.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all of his holy church.
Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servants may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for a faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended, and when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end to the acclaim. Supper is ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension to heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, or the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servants whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that they who are united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up from the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. Try to pardon your brothers and sisters too, and to more who please him to you. At the passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you wipe away every tear from our eyes, for seeing you are God as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom we bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom is power, and glory is yours,
now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
There's everybody else. You're the only one.
Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy of you to enter my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Please join us in singing our communion song, I Am the Bread of Life.
Hail, Lord, that your departed servants, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Again, thank you for joining us today for this liturgy. We hope that you found this Mass healing. We hope that you found this Mass an opportunity to come together, to support one another, to pray for your loved ones, and to also pray for yourselves as well. Certainly, especially for those who are celebrating first this year, like Thanksgiving and Christmas, Easter next year, first without their loved one, know that God is watching over you. Know that our Lord is watching over your loved one. And even though it may be a new normal, God is with us. He was with us yesterday. He is with us today. He'll be with us tomorrow, no matter what it looks like. And we also know that he yearns to take good care of his people, particularly when they yearn for him, yearn for his comfort. Please bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May the God of all consolation bless you, for in his unfathomable goodness he created the human race, and in the resurrection of his only begotten Son, he has given believers the hope of rising again. Amen. To us who are alive, may God grant pardon for our sins, and to all the dead, a place of light and peace.
Amen.
Amen. So may we all live happily forever with Christ, whom we believe truly rose from the dead.
Amen.
Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit
Amen.
Come down in you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.